Hello. Today we'll discuss remote temperature sensing, and I'll show you how to interface the TMP464 and 468 remote temperature sensors with the Arduino platform, including a brief demonstration and walkthrough of a functioning Arduino sketch. At the completion of this video, you will be able to control the measuring of and read temperature from the TMP468 or 464 using an Arduino Uno. For more information on remote temperature sensing, and to get a copy of the software used, please see the links in the video description. First, we'll talk about remote temperature sensors in general terms to help you gain a better understanding of where these devices are most useful. We'll follow that by discussing the specific features of the TMP464 and 468. Next, we'll discuss n-factor correction, which is essential to ensuring the accuracy of your remote channels, and then we'll cover the configuration of the TMP464 and 468 for quick use. I'll also walk you through a short example sketch which pairs the TMP468 EVM with an Arduino Uno and LCD display. And finally, I'll show you a short demonstration of this code in action. The TMP464 and 468 are both referred to as remote temperature sensors. Remote temperature sensors are unique because of their capability to detect temperature in multiple places in a functionally simultaneous time frame and aggregate that data to a single integrated circuit on your system. The common method for sensing these devices is to monitor a distant PN junction of a BJT. The base emitter voltage of a BJT will change predictably with temperature. This is true for both integrated transistors, which may be included in the components you want to monitor, and external BJTs. This makes remote sensors particularly useful in applications with many heat-sensitive components that require monitoring. Internal monitoring can be done for applications such as FPGAs and processors, which have integrated diodes, and external monitoring can be done for discrete components such as FETs, high-speed ADCs, and DACs. The schematic on the left-hand side of this slide shows a typical setup for the TMP464, which can monitor up to 4 zones simultaneously. Regardless of the device, however, the long traces and wires required for monitoring distant systems can present non-negligible resistance. Many remote and local temperature sensors in the TI library, including the TMP464 and 468, will automatically compensate for a finite amount of series trace resistance. An additional topic you may encounter when searching for your remote sensor is beta variation compensation. There are also unique layout recommendations for remote sensors. You can find more information on these subjects at the links in the video description. The primary functional difference between the TMP464 and 468 devices is the number of channels. The TMP464 has a total of 5 channels, 1 local and 4 remote, and the TMP468 has a total of 9 channels, 1 local and 8 remote. Both of these devices have the same accuracy of plus or minus 0.75C from negative 40 to 125 degrees Celsius, with a typical error much lower than that. Both will cancel up to 1 kiloohm of series resistance, and both have n-factor correction and fault detection, which will help to diagnose connection errors with your remote transistors. If not all channels are to be used, both devices will allow for individual remote channels to be easily disabled. The TMP464 and 468 are both available in a VQFN package. The TMP468 is also available in a DSBGA package. These are very small and can be difficult to solder by hand, but for the purposes of this video, we'll be using the breakaway portion of the TMP468 evaluation module pictured at the bottom of this page. The sensors both use an I2C interface, so they will require external pull-up resistors, but these are also conveniently included in the TMP468 EVM. Because the TMP468 can use 1.7 to 3.6 volts for the supply, we'll be using Arduino Uno and its 3.3-volt logic rail for power. The communication here should be successful, provided you do not exceed the maximum current rating of this pin. The predictability of the BJT used for the remote diode is essential to getting good results. While many remote temperature sensors are designed to work well with a particular BJT, it may not always be practical to monitor your device using an external transistor. For this reason, the TMP464 and 468, as well as other remote temperature sensors, should ideally be able to work with a wide range of BJTs. N-factor correction helps to account for the difference between these transistors. The simplified Ebers-Mole equation tells us the collector current through the attached thermal diode is due to the reverse saturation current, which is a property of the BJT being used, and the voltage across the base emitter junction. In order to eliminate the effect of the reverse saturation current, we switch between 2 different magnitude current sources and evaluate the difference between the base emitter voltages under both biasing conditions. A functional schematic of this method is pictured on the left-hand side of this slide. This delta VBE term is not dependent on I sub S. However, there is an additional factor, represented by the Greek letter eta, that we must consider. This is the device's non-ideality, or n-factor, and may be specified by the manufacturer. The TMP464 and 468 both have registers to hold this value for each channel, so that everyone can simultaneously be monitoring a different kind of transistor. The value of this register is referred to as an adjust, and is related directly to the effective ideality constant of the monitoring transistor. The transistors on the TMP468 EVM have an ideality constant which is extremely close to 1. By plugging this into the equation shown, we find that the end adjust value needed to compensate is 17, or hex 11. This is what we will set the upper byte of the end factor correction register to within the example code. The table on this page shows the breakdown of the configuration register of the TMP464 and 468, which is located at register address hex 30 for both devices. The upper byte enables or disables the remote channels. Note that bits 15 to 12 only function on the TMP468, which has the extra 4 channels. For the purposes of our demonstration today, only remote channels 1 through 4 will be enabled, so here we will write hex 0F. Bit 7 enables or disables the local temperature sensing of the TMP468. For the demo, we'll enable the local sensor by writing a 1 here. Bits 5 and 6 control the measurement of the device in shutdown mode. When bit 5 is set, the device will only take temperature samples when bit 6 is written high to trigger a one-shot conversion. When complete, bit 6 resets. These will not be used in the demonstration today, so we write zeros to these values in the configuration register. Bits 4 to 2 control the conversion rate when not in shutdown mode. We will set these bits to 101, which corresponds to 2 conversions per second. Table 11 of the datasheet shows how these bits are interpreted. Bit 1 can be read to determine if the ADC is currently busy performing a conversion, and bit 0 is simply reserved. Writes to these registers will be ignored, so we'll write 0 for both of these values. Altogether, we will write the hex value 0F94 to the configuration register in our example code. Before we go through the demonstration, let's quickly step through the code that will be loaded onto the Arduino Uno. The two primary blocks for an Arduino sketch are the setup block, which contains the code to be executed once, and the loop block, which is executed continuously. Inside the setup block code shown on the left, we begin by initializing I2C communication and the LCD display. After unlocking the registers so that they may be written, we configure the TMP468 by writing hex 0F94 as discussed earlier. The local therm register is next set to 26C, with a hysteresis value of 1C. We designate pin 13 as an output for the LED, and we configure pin 2 as an interrupt. We tie the changing of pin 2 to an interrupt service routine, or ISR, identified in our code as just interrupt. You can think of this as a function that is called every time the alert pin on the TMP468 changes values. This triggers the Arduino to turn on the connected LED, so that we can see when we exceed our threshold temperature, even if we aren't actively displaying it. At the very end of the setup block, we set the end factor register as discussed in the previous slides. The set end factor function shown on the right is responsible for this in the code. Inside the loop block code now shown on the right, we want to constantly update the local temperature reading, so the start of each of our loops begins with a read of local temperature, and then a write to the top row of the LCD display. An integer flag is used to tell the program which remote temperature it needs to print. This switch statement will read and print the appropriate temperature, and update the flag accordingly. At the end of each loop, a 2-second delay is inserted to allow for readability. Here's what this code looks like in action. On screen, we see the breakaway portion of the TMP468 EVM, configured to monitor and display temperature to a standard 16x2 LCD display. The local therm limit register is set in our sketch to be 26C, so by placing my finger on the TMP468, I can trigger an alert from the therm pin as shown by the toggling of the red LED. Be careful doing this if you're not properly grounded, as ESD can damage the device. Notice that the top row of the display is constantly updating the local temperature, and the lower row of the display is rotating between the temperature readings of remotes 1 through 4, just as we configured in the code. A schematic for this setup and the sketch used are included in the video description. This concludes the demonstration on how to interface the TMP464 and 468 temperature sensors with the Arduino platform. The schematic, example code, and links to additional sources of information on the topics discussed are included in the video description. Thank you for watching, and stay tuned for additional videos on how to utilize the TI sensing library with Arduino.